Luke's room is on the same floor as mine, down at the end of the long hallway. As we walk hand in hand toward his room, I'm suddenly quite nervous. I figured after countless glasses of wine I'd be a little more confident, but I think the adrenaline has kept me soberer than I should be. He opens the door to his room and gestures for me to enter before him. He flips the light switch, and I see his room is much larger than mine.
"Are you all right?"
he asks as he puts his wallet and keys down on the side table next to his bed. "Yes, I'm good." Luke takes his hat off and fills a glass from a chilled water bottle in the mini fridge.
"Here, drink this,"
he urges. I gladly take the glass from him and drink the contents at once. He sits down on the edge of his bed, and in the light of the room, I can see his face again clearly. We've spent a lot of time in dim light and darkness tonight. His features are lovely. The kindness I saw earlier tonight is still there in his baby blue eyes, and he seems calm and confident. He's looking at me, and I realize he's waiting for me to make the first move. I fold my arms across my chest and smile at him and kick off my shoes. He smiles back and takes off his boots. Yep, my cowboy is wearing cowboy boots, and it's adorable. Snakeskin, no less. I start to unbutton my blouse slowly as I keep my eyes fixed on his. He leans back on his elbows on the bed and smiles as he watches me undress. I let the blouse slip off my shoulders, and I drape it over the couch. As I start to unzip my skirt, Luke pulls his shirt over his head without undoing the buttons. My lower regions vibrate at the sight of him sitting bare-chested on the edge of his bed, with his erection pressing his dress pants out in the most obvious way. My skirt slips down past my hips and falls at my feet. I step out and bend down to pick it up off the floor, and he enjoys the full view of my cleavage as I do. I flip the skirt over the couch where my blouse is and wait to see his next move. He sits upright and holds his arms out for me to come to him. I slide up in front of him, and my pert breasts and hard nipples are right in his face, covered by my attractive lace bra. I'm delighted that I wore my best lingerie tonight, not realizing anyone else would see me in it. Luke presses his nose against my chest and takes a deep breath. He isn't going to move fast. He's going to enjoy every moment of this, and I'm glad he wants to take his time. I'm glad he wants me. He wraps his arms around my waist and slowly slips his hands beneath my panties at the back to caress the skin of my butt cheeks. His hands are so warm and welcome that I close my eyes and let out a moan of appreciation for his gentle touch. I feel my panties being slipped off with his hands as they touch my toes. I slip my feet out of them and stand still, waiting to see where his hands are going to explore next. His ever so gentle touch up my spine is amazing. His eyes are focused on mine as he unlinks the hooks of my bra. The ends snap free at either side of my back, and I can't wait to expose my swollen breasts to his lips. His face is calm and his gaze warm. Luke slowly slips my bra off my shoulders, and I let him take the straps down my arms as I enjoy the gentle tickle of his fingers on my skin. I'm now completely naked in front of him, and so aroused I can barely contain myself. I have no idea what thoughts are racing through his head, and I wonder if he's feeling as instantaneously attached to me as I am to him at this moment. I should feel vulnerable, but I don't. His mouth caresses my left breast while his hand caresses the right. I feel a shiver travel the length of my spine and decide I have to touch him. My fingers fold in between the longer hair at the top of his head as he pulls my body in closer to his. He falls back onto the bed and takes me with him while he searches for my mouth to tongue wrestle with me again. God, he is so sensual and sexy. I've never felt so aroused by the prospect of making love with anyone before. Not even Ethan made me feel this titillated and filled with desire. Is it because this is all so sudden? It's not like me to give my body so easily to a man I hardly know, yet this feels so incredibly right.